queen. They do not have the queen's mandibular pheromone spreading around in there, so they'll start making a new queen. What's going on, bee herders? Got a thunderstorm brewing around us here, so kind of keep an eye on that. So this will be part two of the trap through trap out. It's been exactly 2 weeks. We've come back over today to check it out, see what's going on. I've actually checked it a couple of times, but not been in it. So today we're actually going to do an inspection, see what's going on inside. I do not expect the queen to have come out yet, so we brought a frame of partially capped, uncapped, and eggs brood that we're going to add to it and allow them to make a new queen out here. All right, we're going to open her up and kind of see how things are going. I'm going to make a decision whether or not to go ahead and add that frame of brood or not. If the queen's not in there, which again, I seriously doubt she is, then we'll add that frame of brood. But I think we've got a fairly solid box of bees. One thing we have noticed, and I noticed this the other day, a couple small holes down here where we misdrilled when we were building our frame. I actually stuck some sticks in there fairly tightly and hammered them in. You can see the couple over here. Well, they managed to get this one out, and they're going in and out of that hole. So we've got to fix that problem. I'll crawl up here and we'll kind of take a look at what we've got.
By the way, that was your green hand, not mine.
My green hand. Whatever fingers, McGillicuddy. You say so. We've got a couple of frames worth of bees in here. We're going to kind of pull the frames out so we can check out and see what our cone is doing, if it's still doing its job trapping them out. We've stuck everything down nicely. So if you remember, we put in 6 or 7 frames of drawn comb that was empty. It was comb from our recent honey harvest. And you can see what they're doing. They filled it with nectar, bee bread. Honey on that side of that one.
Mm-hmm.
Stood it down. Come on, rain, stay away. Oh, yeah. So this frame is interesting. They have really loaded it up. With nectar and bee bread. I'll show you what's interesting, and it tells me now's the time to give them that brood. They've built 3 queen cups on that frame.
Okay.
Now, honeybees will build queen cups all the time just for practice anyway. But I'm fairly certain they've built these cups wanting to put an egg in it. The problem is they don't have any eggs to put in it. We're going to give them some eggs. Some very young larvae that they can put in here. tell you, we've got a full colony of bees, probably 6 or 7 frames worth of bees in here, so we're definitely trapping them out. One thing to remember too is that all of these bees that we've trapped out are foragers. You know a little bit about, there's queen cups everywhere. Know a little bit about the life cycle of the honeybee. The forager is the last job they do before death. So they have the ability to revert back to previous jobs. We don't have any nurse bees out here. So if I put eggs in here, who's going to feed them? Well, I promise you some of these foragers are going to go back to their previous job of being a nurse bee and take care of it. I'm gonna pretend to be Mike for a minute. Look, there's Mike. It's great, Mr. Greenfingers. So here's our cone. We still got bees coming out of it, unable to get back in it. You can see even now, after 2 weeks, we've got foragers who are still trying to figure out how to get back in over there. They can't do it. Not gonna happen. Listen to that sound. So we're 2 weeks into what's going to take at least 6 weeks, I'm sure, in my finger. Okay, so here's the frame we brought from home. We loosely wrapped it in some damp paper towels to keep it moist because we do not want this larva and these eggs to dry out. They're only a few miles from home. So they've not been off of the colony they were on very long. And we can see we've got some very tiny larvae and eggs over here. Heck, there's even a nurse bee that's hatched out since we pulled it. And we've got various stages of larval development here along with eggs as we move out here on the edge. So this will give them what they need to make their own queen. Now, why are they going to make their own queen? Because you may ask, well, they have a queen. She's just in the wall. Well, in order for the colony to know that there is a queen present, they have to physically spread her mandibular pheromone. It's not a pheromone. It just floats along in the air, and everyone says, hey, we have a queen. So the bees that touch her touch other bees, and they just spread that mandibular pheromone throughout the colony, and that reassures everyone and lets them know that we have a queen present in the colony. So as long as they can do that, and there is the presence of uncapped brood, they'll be happy. They won't try to make a new queen. But take any one of those two away, especially the queen, for about 3 weeks, and that's when that laying worker issue is going to start showing itself. So we're going to give them the cap brood, or uncapped brood rather, something that they can make a queen. They do not have the queen's mandibular pheromone spreading around in there, so they'll start making a new queen. What will probably happen here over the course of the next few weeks is we'll basically have a queen castle built out here. It'll make queens, we'll pull them until eventually the mother queen will come out. That's going to take a while, and we'll talk later on as we get into this process about why it takes her so long to get out. So we're going to add this frame and get them buttoned back up. another use for the old Coroplast you see us using all the time. Inner covers. Only problem with them, unless I cut a hole in it, they're really waterproof and airproof. So you could have some condensation issues, but it does keep the bees from propolizing down the lid. Okay. They're buttoned back up. We'll get the strap back on them. We'll get this hole patched up down here. Give them a few days, come back, and I bet you they've drawn a queen cell. We'll see. Okay. We've got them all buttoned back up. We've got the brood in there. We'll give them about 10 days. We'll come back and see what they're doing with regards to making themselves a new Royal Highness, a new queen. Until the next video, y'all keep on keeping on, because we are.